Far beyond witches and wizards is the root cause of health problems of many in Africa. Seek professional advice concerning that your health matter.
I see with my clear eye. The eye that I cannot be ever used in 2 years ago, I use it now to see everything. And I say, may God who make this man have this mind and all these doctors will be here. God will bless them and give them more life.
Join Dr. Save a Life Foundation.
You and your health with Dr. Richard Okoye.
Now on AIT every Monday by 9:30 a.m.
Hello, nice to come your way in this special edition of You and Your Hair. Today is gonna be a bombshell because we're gonna reveal so many things we never knew that these kind of things are happening in the time we are when it has to do with our hair. Listen to me. That thing that you are passing through, or you know your loved one passing through right now, I can tell you, there's much more available to be done in same situation, unfortunately not available or known to our people, and that's the reason why we are coming up today to expose medical treatments in the eyes of new technology. You know quite well that when they say that someone's heart has failed, it invariably implies that the person is dead. But I have the opportunity to show you a man living heartlessly. Oh, come on. Is that the right grammar to actually apply here? Yeah, anatomical heartlessness. That's what I mean. Not the one of your wickedness, but the one that anatomically a man is heartless. Have a look at this. This young man you see here, I will explain to you, looking dead, isn't he? Unfortunately, this young man had a problem called cardiomyopathy and the heart stopped. The heart was not working. But here he is, and I will tell you the transformation of this heartless young boy as we make progress. I want to use this opportunity to encourage you to invite your friends, your loved ones. Let us shift our mind a little from all of these traditional religious narratives we have when it has to do with our hair. And today's edition, we're going to show a lot of things, mysteries or miracle, as you may describe it, happening in healthcare. I want you to stay tuned, call your friends. I will be right back as I will show you what happened in a case of liver failure, what happened in liver cirrhosis, what happened in a cancer, what happened in heart problems, what happened in the area of infertility, what happened in the area of the lungs, what happened in several areas of our lives. Stay tuned. I'll be right back and we'll take it off from here.
Hello. I am Pastor Barrister Austin Nnadi, the Country Director of Dr. Save a Life Foundation. I'm inviting you to join this life-changing and destiny-reforming foundation today. You can be part of it by calling those numbers that are running on your screen right now or visit our website on www.drsavealife.org. Together, we can save a life.
You and your health with Dr. Richard Okoye.
Now on AIT. Every Monday by 9:30 a.m.
Welcome back. You are still on You and Your Health, a program sponsored by Dr. Save a Life Foundation, a non-governmental organization with a clear vision of giving total health to the people of Africa through the power of knowledge. And in today's edition, we are going to discuss something that has to do with medical treatment in the eyes of new technology. I earlier showed you a young boy, which I will explain to you how a man is living today, but without a heart. Without the heart, you know that is the principal thing, that anybody who does not have a heart is dead. But it is being bypassed in our own time. Regrettably, all what we know about a lot of technological advancement when it has to do with the issue that has to do with your cars. You know, a lot of features are coming up right now technologically. You also talk about electric cars. We are talking about the ones that don't even drive. Nobody drives. They say driven cars. They are coming. You look at the internet world. You can now make a call, video call, this other world. Yes, we all know that everything that has to do around us is technologically being renovated. But a lot is also going on in hell, which majority of us do not know. And today we're going to start off with the issue that has to do with organ transplant. Organ transplant. Is it possible that any of the organs or all of the organs of the body can be moved from one person to another person? And if it is so, how and why? And I will put across to you right now, number one thing is that let's look at the liver. One thing you should understand about the liver is that of all of the major organs in the body, liver is only one. And that's why it should be able to preserve your liver. If you're alcoholic, too bad and too bad news for me to tell you this morning, if it's possible for you to stop. Somebody will say, no, it's my life to live. You are not just living your life, you are living your life for your family. You are living your life for your loved ones. You know what? Your presence as a man in your family is a moral booster to your children with or without money. And that's why you don't have to kill yourself. You don't have to become hopeless and want to take your life because things are not working. Your presence can make a difference. Your advice to your children. That's why whatever that should affect your health, you should put a hold on it, knowing there is a future you can still hold on. Alright, now looking at this way, the liver is something that is only one by this side of the body. And you know what? This liver could be affected by a number of things, ranging from the issue that has to do with alcoholism, which can tilt you to what is called liver cirrhosis. Let's look at the liver. If you look at this, this is the normal shape of the liver. This is also the normal color. Of course, you eat liver and you know the brand of liver, all right? The way, you know the texture of the liver, all right? That is how you could see this. Fine, that is normal. There's a gallbladder under it, all right? However, there could be a situation where there could be damage to the architecture of that very liver and it will turn like good. Just picture a loaf of bread exposed under hammer time. You know how it used to be? Perfect. So you can have such a case. This is what is called liver cirrhosis. It has become like that kind of dry bread. It's not going to perform the functions that the liver should be able to perform. So under this situation, you will see the man having yellowness of the eyes. You see the man's tummy sometimes, you know, getting big. And of course, the person will definitely look sick. Such a situation where this very person has a problem, in the modern technology, a person who has liver failure, secondary to this kind of liver cirrhosis, secondary to issue of PLCC, primary cell liver carcinoma, or anything that can bring about liver failure, that person can benefit from liver transplant. But you know the interesting thing about liver transplant? Quite unlike kidney transplant, where you're going to take one from the person and give to the other person, 100%. But everybody has one liver. So if you give out the whole, why would you also survive? But the good news about liver transplant today is that a portion of the liver of someone can be given to a compatible recipient. And the most interesting thing that happened in liver transplant is that if this is cut and give to this person, within 6 weeks to 3 months, the two liver, both the one given and the one that was removed, can grow back to equal portion. An interesting thing. And that's why you see a number of people right now receiving liver transplant and can still be able to live again. That is one good thing that has happened when it has to do with a man having liver-related problem the issue of liver transplant is possible. Now, in our world, the two, both the donor and the recipient, can still be able to live normal life again. A good news, isn't it? And one thing about this is that it has less of rejection tendency compared to kidney and some of the other organs. Now, we go further. Also, on the issue that has to do with kidney failure. A lot of things can make the kidney to fail. And that's why I want to encourage everyone. Be careful of what you take in the name of drugs, in the name of supplements, in the name of whatever that goes into this year body. Seek professional advice about them. Because whatever misses this very liver, because whatever you take in, it goes to the liver tries to manage the toxicity of it. If it couldn't handle it, it will push it away. Where is it going? Right to the kidney. And if the kidney could not be able to cope, it will pack. That's why we are having a lot of kidney failures in our environment today. But still, in the midst of such unfortunate situation, there is hope. Today you can do what is called kidney transplant when in a situation the kidney fails. And don't forget that the commonest cause of kidney failure in our environment is diabetes. Manage that diabetes well to preserve your kidney. Nevertheless, when the worst case scenario happens, you can still benefit from kidney transplant. Of course, you know that before now, people fly abroad and say that I'm going to go and do kidney transplant. But the good news it is to our people today, at least to in a very possible proof, you don't need to fly abroad again to have kidney transplant done in a number of cases. Because right now, Zenith Hospital, St. Nicholas Hospital, and a number of hospitals here in Nigeria has been able to do kidney transplant successfully, and the patients are living. They are all living and doing well. So this is one major innovation coming up, and the good news is that some of these things can happen in this country this time.
You and your health with Dr. Richard Okoye.
Ignorance is the mother of personal destruction. A voluntary misfortune, and it is worse when you are ignorant of your ignorance. Doing something same way, expecting a different result, is another demonstration of madness. If you have done what you think you know concerning that your health problem, why not seek for professional advice? If you lose money, you lose something. But if you lose your health, you lose everything. Hear this, you don't need things to enjoy life. You need life to enjoy things. Give your health professional attention.
You and your health with Dr. Richard Okoye. Now on AIT, every Monday by 9:30 a.m.
Welcome back. You are still on You and Your Health. I'm Dr. Richard Okoye. And today, we are looking at medical treatment in the eyes of new technology. We know a lot when it has to do with technological advancement in other areas, but much more has also been done when it has to do with the issue that has to do with the health of our people. Today you have what is called heart attack. And heart attack, what is it? When there is a narrowing or a blockage of the blood vessels of the heart called the coronary artery. When such happens, this very person can collapse, and this person, if there be no intervention, this fellow can be gone. At this very point in time, if there be a situation somebody has a blockage of the heart vessel, that thing can be reopened by doing what is called, first of all, you go through what is called angiography, and from angiography, you could be able to do what is called angioplasty. A situation where you can have this. This is what is called angiogram. It's showing where the heart is blocked. You can also do what is called angioplasty. That where that heart is blocked can be reopened and a stent can be passed into that to stabilize that very heart vessel. And this other person can live. You know the story of Bernie Sanders, the presidential aspirant of Democratic Party. In the just concluded dispensation, he had a heart attack during campaign. Couple of hours later, he went and did this, and back to his own campaign. Majority of our able-bodied, majority of our people that are supposed to be putting value to our society had that attack and they all gone. Such is available today that by reason of a very established cath lab, such intervention can also be done. And let's go a little further. The greatest frustration we have in our society today is the problem that has to do with fertility. Most times you see couples that love themselves, got married, only because of the issue of childbearing, you see a lot of divorce, separation. Most people are together, perhaps because of their religious bondage. And they just have to be there. But ideally, because of the issue of childbearing, it's no more. But you know what? The technology of today says, as long as a woman has a good womb, she stands the chance of being a mother, only time and chance will happen. And hysteroscopy, a camera evaluation of the womb, can show whether the womb is good or bad. And today you can see a lot of women, 50-something years, over 60 years. Now, have a look at this.
I am former Miss Samba Manuel. I am 62 years old, while my husband is 70 years old. Since we got married, we've been searching for the fruit of the womb. Actually, I went into menopause. God has to revisit my case.
11 after.
Made it possible. The flow came three months. After the 3 months flow, he gave me 3 children after 33 years.
Interesting. But must you have to wait for this age? No. That's why I said it is good when you have a challenge, do not start with the unknown. Do not start with the spirit. Why not call on your doctor? Why not seek professional advice from your doctor first? Did you know? Most people that died of one health-related problem or the other, they died because of the person they met that got them advice at that early stage. If you have a health problem, why not seek professional advice? Hear me and hear me well. If your problem is poverty dependent, tell God the truth. Don't use witches and wizards to confuse a lot of people. Because majority of people that are suffering what they are suffering simply because there is no money. And when there is no money, they will not be able just to come out and say, look, it's because of some even that have, they have a value for money more than their health. That's just the thing. But the fact remains, start from the known. Seek your doctor's advice concerning that your health matter. You may not go wrong. Start with your doctor first.
I'm more than 50. But God, in His mercy and grace, today I can breastfeed.
I never dreamt in my life to be in India, neither enter plane before I die at the age of 70.
My vote of thanks to Dr. Save their life. I'm very happy with them. They've not revived my life again, no matter the age. Now, I feel I can live a little longer than I could have lived.
You and your health with Dr. Richard Okoye. Now on AIT, every Monday by 9:30 a.m.
Welcome back. I do hope you are getting something here. The summary of what we are bringing here is that there are so many things available in our time today. Did you know that issue that has to do with prostate enlargement, that today you could be able to be in position to relieve an obstruction following a benign prostatic hypertrophy, that's enlargement of the prostate. You can get it done without tearing the body open. That is what is called TRP, or what is called transurethral resection of the prostate. You can also do another one that is called laser prostatectomy. But do you know what happened? Most of these things used to happen outside the country. But today, in a number of hospitals in Nigeria, we have seasoned, proven urologists that could be able to excellently take this very issue that has to do with TRP. They can. It's available. Don't go and be drinking all manner of things in the name of, it's an attack, it's a demon. Get in touch with your doctor. Advice can make a difference. Advice can make a difference. Let me finally show you something. You know, before this, when people have back pain or waist pain radiating down to the body, and they say it's a spinal surgery. As soon as they say it's spinal surgery, since I say, oh, the worst is happening. No. Today, you could be in position to do what is called endoscopic decompression of a spine. A spine, this problem and all that. Most of this thing can be done, and the person will be able to walk painlessly again. If you have a look at this, and you can see this one, that the pain, look at what, this is what is called dyshiniation. And the endoscopic laminar discectomy can be done to be in position to remove the obstruction. Interestingly, these things are all possible. Many people are dying today with back pain, waist pain, and pain radiating down, and living it as if it is a lifestyle. No. A lot, I can tell you, can be done when it has to do with intervention. And the same thing is also applicable that today a lot of things can be done also on the joint. When somebody may have and not able to work or having a form of abnormality, okay, leg or bow leg because of arthritis, such things also available in our country. I'm not talking about you now flying outside the country. They are all available in our country. When you could have joint replacement, hip or knee or whatever, can be done. Even the latest one of painless and minimal stitch, knee replacement surgery. All these things are possible. If you have a look at this experience, you see a woman with bow leg, you see the same woman dancing a couple of days later.
Come and see what the Lord has done for me. Come and see what the Lord has done for me.
And you could also see there's a woman exercising. And you now see the same woman dancing as though back to glorify God in the church. A lot of things can be done. The summary of it here is that why not start from the known before you go to unknown? That very thing you don't understand concerning that your health matter, why not ask Western now? To a very large extent, if we're able just to begin to appreciate the value of development in healthcare, Nigeria's health quality will definitely improve as we targeted by 2025.
When your health with Dr. Richard Okoye.
Now on AIT every Monday by 9:30 a.m.
Welcome back. The Vision 2025 is a reality. And many have actually questioned, how possible could it be that Nigerian life expectancy could move from 55 to 70 years by 2025? Here is a good news. In addition to this very wonderful health education program, we have something that will be able to put this information in the hand of our people by 2021. I have a software company in America, and we have been able to come up with a solution that from 2021 January, you will have a medical doctor called Dr. DrSaveAlife. It's a medical artificial intelligence that will be in position to be your companion, your health companion from 2021. This is a huge project being used in America. We are looking forward to launching this in Africa 2021. And good news I have for everyone, that I'm sowing this as a seed, free for all Nigerians. It is a reality that you could be in position to know what to do and do it. Even where there is no doctor, you can know what to do. And that's one of the key things, that this very app is going to be like a doctor.
Are you consulting for yourself? Select your main complaint. When did you first notice the fever?
and order, this will give you the opportunity to have a knowledge of what is happening to you. If there are things that does not require hospital intervention, you could also access it here. Even all the pharmacies in Nigeria, all the drugs in Nigeria, all the hospitals in Nigeria, and everything that has to do with medical emergency. Where there is no doctor, what could you do? Yeah, just call on Dr. Save a Life app. It's going to be a free download for all Nigerians, and the usage is free. It's going to be a great news. I want you to begin to believe that 2025 is a reality. And we say to God be the glory that such happened in our time. And as proud as we are, that this technology originated from Africa. Good news. And all the features, including the ability to scan the drugs you take, will be delivered to you in subsequent editions. So you watch out for Dr. Save a Life, you download it from the Play Store, and you use as your own companion right there on your phone. The details and other things I will let you know. Just believe it is possible.
You and Your Health with Dr. Richard Okoye.
Now on AIT, every Monday by 9:30 a.m.
Welcome back. You are still on You and Your Health. I'm Dr. Richard Okoye, and today we are looking at medical treatment in the eyes of new technology. We know a lot when it has to do with technological advancement in other areas, but much more has also been done when it has to do with the issue that has to do with the health of our people. This young man you see here had what is called cardiomyopathy. This young man you see could not be in position to, he was lifeless, the heart was not working. But today you can see the young man being stronger than most of us that we call our people healthy. He is using an artificial heart. A number of them also have done issue of the heart transplant and they are living. That is the world we are, that so many things are becoming possible, and it is time for us to be in position to appreciate it. I do hope this very program has been a blessing to you and your family. I encourage you to support it. You could call on any station. You can even pay in any station in your own locality. We can give you tips and let this knowledge be getting to our people. You can call upon this very station to be here. Of course, you know it's not poverty friendly. But you can call on them and say, please, I want to support You and Your Health program by Dr. Save a Life Foundation here or any station wherever. We will deliver the tips that can help our people know what to do and doing it at the right time. And also, I beckon on you in our free feeding program for the less privileged. You can support or whatever you have, you can contribute on this very account, or you can even give up. Don't hide palliatives. Don't hide palliatives. You can give us the palliative to help us to feed the less privileged. They say that Nigeria has gone into recession. Think about what the poor will suffer this time. But we can be in position to give them hope by providing them for now. Definitely there will be a turnaround for Nigerian economy soon. God bless you for doing that.
You and Your Health with Dr. Richard Okoye is brought to you by Dr. Save a Life Foundation.